Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to another video by my good buddy here, Exceed. He's going to be showing you his new Floodgate Dark Magician, so go ahead.
Yeah, man. It's fun if you're not going against it.
Yeah.
It's pretty spicy. First things, obviously, three Dark Magicians. Don't run any less, because three is good enough, man. Three is good. Always. Three of her. Sometimes I would cut her down to two or three, but she's situational sometimes. Of course, you have to run the best Stratos of the deck. Rode. He's so good.
Spelltrap Stratos.
Yeah, he is. This guy, because he's level 7, and if he can summon a Dark Magician from Graveyard.
And himself.
And also he's a target for Power of Desires and Allure, so on and so forth. Run two Monks and one Magician, Chocolate Magician Girl. I run Baguska in here, Allure Target, and Desires. Chocolate Magician Girl is amazing. You can sit on her, legit, and if your opponent doesn't know what she does, they'll always attack this thing and summon yourself a Dark Magician, and they'll have fun against that. I had a lot of people doing that in my locals.
Yeah.
It was pretty spicy.
Subscribe for the playmat.
Three of this. Always have to run three.
What is this?
Oh, it's circle, my dude. It's like...
I thought it was Dark Magical Square.
Oh, I know, right? It is a square, if you can't tell.
It's on a square card.
But other than that...
Rectangular.
Other than that... Good card. Duality for Dark Magicians, but better. I have Tamias, don't run three. This can sometimes make you brick, but if you have Monk, he can be a target for Monk. So, and another target for Desires. One Inheritance. You could run two, but with this deck, I don't need the second one. One Illusion Magic. Search out Dark Magicians. Haha! Best card to draw into. Oh. This card is...
This is our team name right here, guys.
Yeah.
Three
team,
Zires.
Yeah. Team Three Zires. Join us if you have...
If you run three Zires, you have to run a playset of Zires in every single one of your decks.
Also, Desires could make you lose sometimes, but it could be it could be your friend and it could be your foe. Cause if you banish two of your Dark Magicians, you can't play the game.
And for any of you unbelievers of Desires, it's very hard to make it be your foe.
Yeah, I just friend. If you just have bad luck with it, so. Like I did against Days over here. He can tell you about that later. Best draw power, Allure of Darkness. All your monsters besides Chocolate is dark. So. And then two of these, because it's other good draw power. You don't really special summon during your turn very much. Especially during your first turn, you don't ever special summon.
Except for...
Oh yeah, except for Illusion, Apprentice Illusion, or for Baguska, but other than that, three of this, because it's the best trap for magicians. Oh, the worst trap, but best trap, Eternal Soul.
Worst but best.
The worst but best because, good because it can special summon Dark Magicians from...
It can trigger Dark Magical Circle every freaking turn.
Yeah. But the problem is, if you don't have Dragon Knight to protect this, and your opponent takes this out of field, instant Raigeki for yourself. So,
yeah.
So note about that. That's why I only run two. Don't run three. Three could kill you. Ooh, on to the spicy part. Two of this, and one of this.
Or two.
Or two, but for now, one. Because some decks could have one type, and others may have multiple, since this archetype is mostly spellcasters. YuGiOh. Also, this thing, activate this first before you activate anything that special summons. Because if you activate something that special summons a Dark Magician, you can't activate this. And this will not affect your Dark Magicians since they're normal monsters. And this thing counts as two cards. So basically you're running four of these. And I'm getting a third one soon, so I'll... So it's pretty Gucci. The next thing is the Solemn Engine, you know.
It's your boy, Solemn Engine.
Yeah, man.
Negating since 2016. I hate that card.
This needs to be at two.
It seems that you always lose games whenever you use a strike and a warning.
I know, right?
You go down like so many life points.
I know. On to the extra deck. One Dark Paladin. If you get lucky and go against dragons, this thing will be boosted to max. And if you have this on field, and if you have a lot of cards in your hand, you can negate as many spell cards as you want, my dude. And the best fusion monster, this guy. So good, because he counts as Dark Magician on your field. Or in your graveyard, so you can use Eternal Soul to summon him, and then he protects your back row, and Eternal Soul protects him, basically. So, good card. Oh, my favorite card of the deck, Baguska. I shouldn't talk about him very much, everyone should know what he does already. The one number 39 Utopia Beyond. So you do run Apprentice, and this guy's situational because when he's Exceed Summoned, he turns all your opponent's monsters to zero attack, and he's 3k beat sick, so yeah. This guy, you don't really summon him, but if you want, and activate your trap cards in your hand, I guess, go ahead.
And quick play spells.
And yeah, quick play. Spell good, stupid. I run this card, number 28, Titanic Moth. I found a use for him now. If your opponent activates Max C, spam as many monsters as you can, then summon this guy, and they will regret using Max C. Good card against Max C. I run two Ebon Illusion Magician. I might actually cut him to one due to I'm running so many floodgates. I'm limited to my extra deck. So, but he's good to summon Dark Magicians, and if a normal spellcaster attacks, he can banish stuff. Number 11, Big Eye Finesser, you know? Finesses stuff, and they don't get it back. So, amazing card. I don't know why I'm running him, but he just looks cool. And, extra deck filler, you know?
I'm dying over here.
Oh, Red Eyes Flare Metal Dragon. Oh!
Tell the story, please.
So... So I was against a Trickstar player, and so he attacked into my Chocolate Magician Girl, making me summon my Dark Magicians, or Dark Magician from Graveyard. I got him to 200 life points, summoned this guy, And by the way, this is a trickstar player, and he was at 200 life points. So if he could activate anything, he would lose.
You outburned
a trickstar. I outburn a trickstar with dark magicians. And then he all of a sudden, he's like, oh, I can cheat all of a sudden, but Seth here can tell you that story later.
Yeah, about him.
And then the Link monsters, you don't really go into Link very much, but if you want, Gaia Saber and Proxy Dragon. You can use Decode Talker, but honestly, with lose one turn, that's not gonna really help you very much. And that's it.
Also, guys, a shout out to Exceed for going 3-1 at his first ever locals.
Yeah, man.
You did pretty good. He lost to me because he's a scrub.
Desires did it again.
Yeah, he banished doubled our mission, guys. But don't let that discourage you. Desires is an amazing card, and you should run that. Go team 3 Desires. I'll see you guys in the next one.